Well, this is a story all about how my life got flipped, turned upside down. And I'd like to take a minute, just sit right there. I'll tell you how I became the prince of a town called Bel Air. In West Philadelphia, born and raised, on the playground is where I spent most of my days. Chilling out, maxing, relaxing, all cool and all, shooting some b-ball outside of the school. When a couple of guys who were up to no good started making trouble in my neighborhood. I got in one little fight and my mom got scared and said, "You're moving with your auntie and uncle in Bel Air." I whistled for a cab and when it came near, the license plate said fresh and it had dice in the mirror. If anything, I could say that this cab was rare, but I thought, nah, forget it, yo, home's the Bel Air. I pulled up to the house about 7 or 8 and I yelled to the cabbie, "Yo, home, smell you later." Looked at my kingdom, I was finally there to sit on my throne as the Prince of Bel Air.
Kids. Let's hear it for the 19 kids. Woo! Love these guys. Love these guys. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. We're gonna play a little game tonight that I like to call "You're Doing It Wrong." You know, if you're still a freshman and you're eating in the hallways, I'm afraid you're doing it wrong. You're doing it wrong. I'm sorry. You know, if you're playing yard games and you're breaking a sweat, you're doing it wrong. You're doing it wrong, people. Okay, don't break a sweat during yard games. All right, you know. And if you're not coming to school with you know, a bucket of ice water and a 6-inch ski jacket, you're doing it wrong, folks. Because the AC in here, you know. Somebody call the janitor. Am I right? You know, if you're walking into math class without a neck pillow, you're doing it wrong. You're doing it wrong. And if you're walking from the J lot and you don't have a scooter, if you're still walking, you know what, it takes me like 9 minutes for the scooter, it takes me 3, you're doing it wrong, folks. You're doing it wrong. And if your parents still know the password to Genesis and you haven't changed it, I'm afraid you're just doing it wrong. You're just doing it plain wrong, folks. All right, so we got some great segments lined up for you guys. You know, some brilliant people, brilliant actors, brilliant faces. I'd like to send it back to the studio, but before that, let's hear it from 19 kids.
Save the Music, we've raised over $20,000 so far. Debbie went down to CPAC tired and need to rest his feet. He walked 10 long miles to get here and he wanted to take a seat. When he came across a tall boy playing sax on a swivel chair, the devil came up behind him and said, "Kid, I got you again."
Superman's got nothing on me. Trump made a splash when he sat down with Megyn Kelly in a slightly awkward interview.
Our very own Catherine Visco sat down with President Oliver Jones.
Let's see how he'll make CHS great again.
Chatham High School has never seen a political juggernaut like Oliver Jones. Recently winning his fourth election, Jones electrified freshman voters in 2013 and rode that wave for a four-year term in office. I'll sit down and get inside the mind of the political prodigy on this week's episode of 60 Questions.
Tonight on this episode of 60 Questions, we will be interviewing the newest and longest running president at Chatham High School, Mr. Oliver Jones.
Hi, it's nice to meet you, Catherine.
Nice to meet you. The biggest question is, where are you getting all of this money from? We know that we are the most densely money populated class, but where are you getting this money from? It seems that there are barely any fundraisers.
Well, that's an interesting question. I get it a lot. It comes down to really good planning. Our freshman year sweatpants sale was very, very successful. There have also been some external fundraisers that weren't completely shared with students in the class.
About your plans to build a wall between Lafayette and high school.
Well, I think it's important that we make sure that Lafayette pays for this wall. Lafayette is... Really, they're poor. The kids pouring in, traipsing through the halls.
Over your past 3 years as president, have there been any failures? Something that you're not proud of in your presidency?
Failures, or rather, lacks of success. We tried to promote the use of toothbrushes, and that's actually one of the big reasons why the breathalyzer policy was instituted, because we couldn't get people to brush their teeth. We couldn't get them to purchase these toothbrushes. So now, you know, we have to do random breath checks, which is not something that we originally wanted to do, but it's a resort that we had to resort to. Whoops.
Bribed some underclassmen to kind of enforce and kickstart your campaign this year.
Well, all of that, all of the speculation behind bribery and you know all those hot and button words that the media like to play with, my emails and my server. It's going to be a lot of boring stuff. There's nothing you would ever find suspicious in those emails.
What should we expect for the reunion?
As I did mention in my speech, I'm going to make arrangements. I'm going to contact Gerald Fordson, who is a friend of my brother's friend's former roommate. He owns a depot for mechanical bulls, as I previously stated. So I was thinking we'd bring 50, 60, 70 of those. The C gym is, you know, as far as venueing is concerned, we stack them vertically rather than the traditional horizontally across the floor. I'm thinking we have enough space. I mentioned hang gliding lessons, which is something that we can do on the roof. I know that there's roof access. Whether you're 25 or whether you're 70, you know, who doesn't like hang gliding?
Senior prom theme, any suggestions or ideas?
One idea that's been floating around in my head, and I'm sure other people's, is Vuvuzela. Those were horns used in the FIFA World Cup. Very, very annoying. They sound really pretty awful. Probably 2,000 of them. You know, I actually know a guy who has a depot for Vuvuzelas. And if we give them out at the door, then we don't even have to pay for DJ.
This was such a wonderful interview. I was really hoping for a construction theme for the senior prom, but I mean, of course, the horns. Great idea.
I'd just like to say thank you to anyone that's watching this interview. It gives me great pleasure to be involved in a Pulse segment.
Thank you. Tune in next week for our special edition with the head chef at Arminio's.
before the borough and the township came together to form Chatham High School, the township used to have the Senior Awards Assembly, which we currently have the day after the Bell Awards.
All right.
And the borough had the Bell Awards, or also called the Outstanding Achievement Awards. So the goal at the time was, when they brought the two schools together, was to bring traditions from each building to the new Chatham High School, which has been around since 1989, I think, or 88.
Wow.
So that's where it came from. I think one of the most impressive things about the Bell Awards is that it doesn't necessarily go to the student who has the best grades or the student who's the best athlete or the best actor in the play. It really speaks to the character of the student that the teacher identifies. So the selection process is about 6-8 weeks ago, nominations went out we seek nominations from the teachers. Mm-hmm. Not every teacher gets to award a bell. But teachers get to nominate students who they think have made a difference in their class, they've grown as students, as people, they've had an impact on the others that they've worked with. So it really talks to the character of the person, which I think is very different than a single achievement. It's really a lifetime achievement. So for me, I think it's one of the most special awards and certainly one of the most special nights that we offer here at Chatham.
It's a really amazing thing to experience, just hearing like the perspectives of the teachers about how the students have impacted them, because we all know how our teachers have impacted us, but hearing it from the other perspective was really powerful for me, and I really enjoyed it.
I felt really good because Mr. Groh explained what it was, like the Outstanding Achievement Award, and he told us that it means like we're standing out in the classroom.
Like the whole like awards sort of surrounded around like the fact that you like impacted a teacher, changed like the class for them. And so, I mean, I was really like proud, I guess. Like it was like a good thing to know that someone put me up for that.
When I award a Bell Award to a student, I find that students who challenge me to become a better teacher, to make some comments or suggestions that aren't just helping the student but helping me grow, are important characteristics that I look for.
Someone who is just a really hard worker and who is always speaking in my class, that's a big thing. And someone who just really shows a love of the language, since I teach French, that's important.
I think each year I just look for someone in class that maybe kind of transforms a little bit in class from the beginning to the end of the school year. Someone that's working really hard and maybe just has a higher level of interest in class, and I see a different level of creativity with them. Somebody that works really hard.
Student who maybe works harder than anybody else. A student who takes particular interest in the subject and does anything that they can to further their understanding. Students who tend to earn Bell Awards, especially from me, are ones who think critically about the subject, that they take ownership of it, they think deeply about it. When something goes wrong in history, they get upset by it. When something goes right in history, they celebrate it. And they're students who seem to enjoy the subject because they learn more about the world around them, not just because they're trying to get an A in class. And that's the student who tends to stand out and shoot.